I think it's disappointing.
Sue Moroney.
Mr. Chair, we've had some very interesting contributions on this, some of which have put some light on this very simple bill that is in fact so simple I think it lasts for about three pages. Too much for the National Party to get their brains around. They find that too complicated. About three pages worth of regulation that simply aims to ensure that people who would consider themselves as being self-employed, as contractors, that they at the very least are able to earn the minimum wage of $15.25. Too complicated for the National Party to get their tiny little brains around. Well, Mr. Chair, I want to ensure that people listening to this debate know that the party opposite is very deliberate in why they are voting against this very good bill. They're deliberate, and I think Parmjeet Parmar, when she gave her contribution, she gave it away, actually. She said, well, the contribution was varied, but the part that I want to concentrate on is when she said that the Marsala restaurant case that a previous member had referred to wouldn't even be covered by this bill anyway because those people were employees. So let's just think about that for a minute. Because in fact, what she's telling the House is that actually this bill would actually mean that it would stop that employer from using another mechanism to not even get into court. Because the only reason that case even got before the court was because they weren't being engaged as contractors. Had they been engaged as contractors, the labour inspectors could never have even prosecuted. And that is the point about this bill, is because it will give labour inspectors the right to actually prosecute, actually investigate and prosecute those dodgy employers who Parmjeet Parmar is instructing to actually use the contracting provision to get around the minimum wage provisions. It would actually prevent that case from even getting to court. So the government opposite is arguing that they want to vote this bill down so that they can ensure that employers like the Marsala restaurant can get away with what they were doing and not be brought before the court, because all they simply have to do is to require those vulnerable people who they were employing to not take up an employment relationship but just pay them, engage them as contractors, and it'll all be sweet. They'll be able to continue to exploit those people. And I think that's a disgrace that the National Party thinks that is okay. Mr. Chair, we've already heard that there's been a premature speculation, I think I'll call it, from Business New Zealand about the fact that this bill, they've announced to the nation that it's been voted down. Well, we've yet to take a vote, actually. And I hope that whoever put that press statement out is, I know that they'll be earning more than the minimum wage. They probably don't deserve to, quite frankly, if they're going to make pronouncements about matters that haven't even taken place yet. But I genuinely hope that they, through their incompetency, have not only prematurely speculated, but that they have got this, in fact, quite wrong. Because I hope that all the parties that have supported this to date actually keep their nerve, hold their nerve in the face of those who want to exploit people who work hard in this country. I hope that every party holds their nerve against those employers who actually do other good employers a disservice. Because the thing I want to say to Business New Zealand is this: the majority of the members who they represent will not be using this provision and this loophole. They are the employers who actually play by the rules, do the right thing, pay people a decent wage for the work that they perform for them. They don't want to have to compete against the dodgy employers who use this loophole to exploit their staff. because that is the race to the bottom. And most employers in New Zealand do not want to engage in that. They don't support what the National Party are doing. They don't support the idea that their competitors, because they have no ethics and no morals, are able to use this loophole to actually pay people less.
Alistair Scott. Thank you, Mr.